It's the most advanced semi-truck ever built. And in order to do that, you had to have massive computing power on board. So we have central servers pretty much that run the whole truck. So unlike most automotive vehicles that you would see, instead of having little tiny computers everywhere, we have more massive computers that can power through any of the data that we need, whether it's torque vectoring controlling the tires, or whether it's analog braking systems, or whether it's autonomous driving that we're also working with Bosch on. Or there's a whole bunch of things. For instance, the infotainment system that controls everything for the driver is all done through this central gateway computer as well. So to build a truck from the ground up the right way, we had to go to a more centralized computer to run the whole thing. I believe the future is going to need a lot of different mobilities to get there. It's not one size fits all. Nikola offers both battery electric trucks, which really help the market up to 300 miles. Anything over 300 miles or any application that's weight sensitive, hydrogen makes a lot more sense. So hydrogen's a lot lighter. It's usually thousands of kilograms lighter than a battery electric equivalent. And it also allows you to fill up within just a few minutes. The advantage to both powertrains is that they're completely zero emission. So there is no emissions associated with those from the tailpipe of the vehicle. So with hydrogen, the additional advantage of hydrogen is that it's easier to control the supply of the energy coming in to produce hydrogen. So you're truly zero emission from production to consumption, something that gets a little more tricky when you get into battery electric. I don't know if they're necessarily afraid. I think they're watching us closely. Most OEMs don't have much fear. They just act or they react. The advantage to Nikola is that we're always leading. We never react to what other people do because we're paving the way for the whole world. So I don't really care what anyone else does because normally we're way ahead of them. And that's the great thing about being a leader is you don't care who's behind you. There's a lot of variables to a hydrogen truck. The main foundation of a hydrogen truck is the fuel cell. And then you have the storage that stores all the hydrogen on board. Well, that is the stuff that's on the truck. The more complicated stuff is what's off the truck. How do you build stations to supply that high pressure, which is 70 megapascal or 700 bar, to that truck? So Nikola's advantage is that we actually don't just design only the truck, we actually design the stations with it. So when we sell a hydrogen truck to one of our customers, we provide the hydrogen station that goes with it. So you have all the compression, you have all the cooling, all the thermal, all the electrolysis through zero emission to create hydrogen. Then you pump it into the truck at 10,000 PSI, or 70 megapascal. So if you think about that, now you're holding hydrogen inside these tanks, compressed, it's the smallest element in the atmosphere, a molecule. And what that allows you to do is compress it very, very tiny. And at 10,000 PSI, you can get a truck that can go over 600 miles now without having to stop for refuel. The great thing about Nikola is that as a startup, you get to do things very fast. As you get closer to becoming a real OEM, everything slows down. And the idea of building this lab is allow us to continue that same speed that we had as a startup, but in a production element or world. So these labs allow us to test every component of the fuel cell. It also allows us to test the dyno and the chassis. And we can also do simulating driving to where the driver's actually sitting right there, driving the vehicle in a virtual reality room with these gigantic screens. And down below him, 60 feet down below him, right below him is the entire powertrain actually running in the same thermal climate that you would have in that situation. So these chambers are heated and cooled. Your whole powertrain is down there running while you're sitting here driving virtually. And it allows you to get to market very fast. It allows you to keep the idea of being a startup while still being an OEM. And that's what these labs are for, is full development from beginning to end all the way to production.